Bench Ashley Cesar, and welcome back to my channel. So our topic for today is about system components. Number one is random access memory, or RAM, is where the data and programs are placed for execution by the CPU. The memory is directly connected to the motherboard through a slot called socket. It is used to store programs that are currently running. It is called random access because it is composed of integrated circuit that allow the stored data to be accessed in random order. And there are three kinds of memory. Number one is RAM, or random access memory, is also called the main memory. Data and programs are placed here while the CPU is processing them. Information in the RAM are lost when power is turned off. Number two is ROM, or read-only memory. It stores important programs, for example, to start the computer. ROM information cannot be changed when power is off. And number three is CMOS, or complementary metal oxide semiconductor. It stores date, calendar, and current time of the computer. It is powered by batteries so that even when the computer is turned off, the information inside stays intact. Number two is internal storage. Internal storage is a device where data, files, and application software are kept for future use. It also holds the operating system that allows the computer to access the input and output devices. The internal storage retains information even when power is turned off. Internal storage is connected directly to the motherboard. That is why it is faster to load the data than data stored from an external storage device. There are two common types of internal storage. Number one is hard disk drive, or HDD. It's a spinning data storage device used for storing and retrieving digital information. Data is accessed in a random order. HDDs are a type of non-volatile memory, retaining data even when the computer is off. Number two is solid state drive, or SSD. Solid state drive, or SSD, is a solid state storage device that uses integrated circuit assemblies as memory to store data while the computer is off. SSD has no moving mechanical components, unlike HDD. The chip can be permanently installed on the system's motherboard, on a PCI or PCIe card, or in a box that is sized, shaped, and wired into slot in a laptop or desktop's hard drive. 3 is power supply unit, or PSU. Power supply unit provides power to the CPU, motherboard, hard disk drive, and other components inside the computer. It contains a transformer, voltage controller, and a cooling fan. Number 4 is video card. A video card is also known as the graphics accelerator, or simply graphics card. It's also a computer component whose main function is to generate video or images to a display such as the monitor. Video cards are installed to improve the quality and speed in which images are displayed. Some video cards have functions such as TV tuner for cable and antenna-based TV viewing, video capture for video cameras, and to connect multiple monitors to one computer system. Number 5 is sound card. A sound card, or audio card, is an internal computer expansion card that facilitates economical input and output of audio signals to and from a computer under control of computer programs. Number 6 is internal buses. Buses carry the data or information around different components in the computer. The types of buses are as follow. Number one is internal bus. It's also called internal data bus, memory bus, system bus, or front side bus, or FSB. It connects all internal components of a computer, such as CPU and memory, to the motherboard. Number two is external bus. Like accelerated graphics port, or AGP, universal serial bus, USB, and FireWire. It connects the different external device, expansion slots, I/O ports, and drive connections to the computer. And lastly is CPU cooling. The CPU chip generates a lot of heat when processing and may burn off if not cooled. A cooling system is needed to ensure that the processor chip is cooled to a level that it operates efficiently. Most processors are provided with cooling fans, but this may not be enough, so external cooling is needed. Heatsink is a metal component attached to the CPU with fins designed to dissipate heat and therefore cool the processor. Heat is absorbed by the heatsink and is dispensed to the air by the fin. Sometimes heat pipes are used to blow heat away. Other computers use water cooling just like the one used in cars. Water from the processor to the radiator-type grill that cools the water, then water returns from the CPU to cool it again. That's all for today. Thank you for your time and listening, and hope you guys like it!